Welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to assemble a monorail view camera. The first thing you need to do is set up your tripod. Rail cameras are quite heavy, so you need to select a tripod that can support the weight of the camera and lens. This is about the smallest tripod you can get away with, and only if you're using a smaller lens. Set up the tripod head so that the front is facing over one of the tripod legs. This will ensure that the lens of the camera has enough support. The first part of the camera is the rail clamp. This is sometimes referred to as the tripod mount. It has a channel through the top that holds the monorail in place. On the bottom, you'll find a standard thread for mounting onto the tripod. If you have a quick-release tripod head, that makes setting up the camera even faster. The rail clamp is the foundation that holds all the other parts of the camera onto the tripod. It's important to make sure that it's completely secure and tight on the tripod head. The next part of the camera is the monorail, or rail. These come in different lengths. You will want to have a larger rail for longer focal length lenses and for focusing close up. Shorter rails are usually used for wide angle lenses or when you only plan to focus into the distance, such as with distant landscapes. Mount the rail by opening the rail clamp and placing the rail into the channel. For most lenses, you want the rail to be centered on the rail clamp. This will ensure the best balance of weight. For wide-angle lenses, you may want to have the rail clamp towards the back of the camera. This will ensure that the rail clamp does not get in the way of focusing. The next parts to assemble are the standards. The front standard and rear standard are exactly the same. They are interchangeable in every way, with all the same knobs and movements in both the front and the back. You will need to position the rear standard so that the frame area is sticking out toward the back. This is important to ensure that the camera parts do not get in the way and you have a clear path to insert the film holders later. The rail has a small spring-loaded pin to prevent the standard from falling off. You will need to push this in to get the standard onto the rail. Once the standard is threaded onto the rail, you should be able to push it forward toward the middle of the rail. If it doesn't push easily, check that the standard is unlocked. There are two knobs at the base of the standard. One will lock or unlock the standard on the rail, and the other will roll the standard forward and back. Now assemble the front standard. It's customary to have the front standard oriented the same way as the rear standard. This makes it easier to use and apply movements because all of the knobs will be oriented in the same way. Again, snap the standard past the spring pin onto the rail. Fortunately, you only have to do this once. The next part is the bellows. The bellows are a collapsible, flexible, accordion-shaped housing that seals the sides of the camera. Be sure to inspect old bellows for damage or pinholes. On either side of the bellows, there's a frame that will fit into the front and rear standard. You will also notice notches on the frame. Those notches must be aligned with the frame on the standard to fit properly. Here is a different type of bellows called a bag bellows. These are typically used for wide-angle lenses. They can expand and collapse just like the standard bellows, but they can collapse much smaller. This allows the camera to be compressed smaller, which is necessary for wide-angle lenses. To attach the bellows, be sure the lock is open at the top of the standard. Place the bellows into the frame and align the notches. When the bellows frame is seated, push the lock lever back into place. Pull the other bellows frame to the opposite standard. Seat it into the frame and lock it into place. Make sure both sides of the bellows are secure. Next, we put the lens board on. For my camera, I have a lens board reducer. It's a large lens board with a place to mount a smaller lens board into it. You can also use a standard lens board. I find the reducing lens board convenient because it allows me to use a smaller lens board. This smaller lens board is interchangeable with my other large format cameras. It allows me to avoid having to remount my lenses when I change cameras. If this is your first time using a view camera lens, please check out my other video that covers basic lens use. Just as you did with the bellows, open the lock at the top of the front standard. It's very easy to move the lock too far, so be careful. The same lock controls both sides of the frame. It's always best to hold on to the most delicate thing whenever you're moving the lock, just to be sure. Now that I have my reducing lens board in place, I can take my smaller lens board with the lens already mounted and place it into position. It tips into a lip on the bottom, and then a lock slides down to hold it into place. Make sure the lens is secure before letting go. The final part of the camera is the ground glass back. The ground glass is in a separate frame with a spring-loaded hinge. This allows you to place film holders into the back of the camera and hold them tightly against the back so no light gets in. A ground glass back like this one is called a graph lock back. It allows the removal of the ground glass frame and the use of numerous different accessories such as roll film adapters. To remove the ground glass, push the spring hinges in to release the frame and slide it out. This frame has two metal sliders that move to lock the accessories in place. To replace the ground glass, realign it within the frame and push the spring hinges back into place. Install the ground glass back on the rear standard just as you did the lens board. Unlock the frame, tip the ground glass back into place and lock it. Be sure it's secure before letting go. You can orient the ground glass back to make a horizontal or vertical picture. Simply remove the back and realign it to the desired position. So that's how you assemble a basic monorail view camera and all of the basic parts. Check back for more videos where I will discuss the basic sequence of photographing and how to use a view camera lens. For this video, this is the end.